Economy is coming out of COVID situation slowly and gradually. There is a favorable interest rate environment. Also, real estate demand is good from last 1 month. Also, favorable money supply. All these factors, how it will affect Indian banking sector? What is the future of Indian banking sector from now onwards? To discuss all that, I welcome you all to my YouTube channel. And please watch this video till end because I am going to show you 5 top stocks, banking stock which you can buy for the good return. Friends, my name is C.A. Tapan Doshi. I am a stock broker. And if you still not open a DMAT account, you can click below link to open a zero brokerage DMAT account. So let's start and let us get a deep dive in the Indian banking sector. First, we'll check how the Indian banking sector has performed. No, means public sector, private sector and all that NBFC, how they have performed in the stock price level in last 1 year. So, if you see here, I'm talking about the last month, September month, you can see that non-frontline private bank has a good return, almost 11%, followed by PSU banks. However, the private bank's return was only 0.5%. And NBFC, frontline private banks and capital market were having a negative return. Now let us see last 3 months. If you see last 3 months, capital market players has performed very well, almost 14%, NBFC 12.4%. Bank it has performed by almost 7.6%. However, PSU bank, which already ran up had an almost a flat return, and also non-frontline banks minus 1.4%. Non-frontline bank, private banks actually had a good return in last 1 month only. Now PSU bank, if you take the last 12 month performance, you can see PSU banks had a very good return of around 110%. However, Bank Nifty was around 75% only, NBFC 67%. So PSU bank was able to give such a good return because lot of NCLT cases were resolved, and like Diwan Housing and all that, that fund they got back, and there was quite a boost in their profitability. Also the NPA level gone down. So that's a PSU bank which was quite undervalued at that time, had a good return in last 1 year. Even NBFC sector, if you take the last 5 years, NBFC sector had performed very well, followed by frontline bank, private banks, also Bank Nifty. If you see PSU banking, if you take the return of last 5 years, it delivered no return. Even the regional private bank and non-frontline private banks had a negative return actually. So actually frontline private banks and for NBFC had given a very good return in last 5 years. You can see in this chart. Now this chart, I am showing you that how the credit card transactions are coming up in last 3 months. Now, if you can see here, in last 3 months, there is July, August, September, there is a good jump in the credit card transaction on the basis of value and also on the basis of volume. This shows the economy activities are picking up slowly and gradually. Debit card transaction, however, at peak in March 21. Now, in last 3 months, it's a okay transactions, but yeah, still not cross the peak of March 21. So, but slowly and gradually, it is also coming up. However, there was a big jump in the UPI payment method. You can see the last 3 months, very big jump. Also, you can see it's sharp, it's slowly and gradually, every month it is increasing. So people are using more and more UPI method or UPI payment mode to do transaction. It is quite convenient also. So this graph may go up for UPI in future also. Now CD rates. CD rates is nothing but a certificate of deposit, or you can say that deposit rates. Now that deposit rates are stable from last 1 year. you can see, because after COVID, RBI also slashed its repo rate, and that's why the rates were down. Also globally, the rates were down. So from last 1 year, you can see that it is almost stable, and also last 3 months also stable. But now in future, once the RBI increase this repo rate, the CD rates may go up, and it may happen because, as you are aware, that US also going to increase their rates from November onwards, November 21 onwards, and the developing economy, also the European countries will follow the suit, and they may increase slowly and gradually. But yeah, it is still some time that they may increase the rates, but slowly and gradually these rates may go up in future. And because currently the rates are down, it is having a favorable impact in the Indian economy, because then only business will come back and start getting more loans, and they will do an expansion. So let's see how it will happen, and how, and again, once the repo rates are increased and everything, these interest rates will affect the inflation rate also. Now, as I told you, that there is a favorable interest rate in the country, and because of that, credit growth was around 7% year over year, and deposit growth was around 9%. You can see here the gray line is of deposit growth and the red line is of credit growth. However, still this is quite low. Even though economy is coming up, the credit growth and the deposit growth is not so robust, as you can see here in 10-11. Of course it was quite high, but if you consider 18 also, it was quite high at that time also. So still it has long way to go, but slowly and gradually it will happen. Now CD ratio, now that is deposit ratio compared to the total deposit is around 70%. Okay, now this is quite low. Earlier in 2019-2008 used to be around 78-79%, but however this is quite low. This should go up, but it will happen in future. But frankly speaking, one of the main reason why it is down is that because the deposit rates are going down, so people are moving away from deposit and they are investing in stock market and any other alternate instruments. But yeah, this is comparatively down. Now you can see here fresh lending rates. Okay, fresh lending rates for private banks increased 20 bps month-to-month, but declined by similar amount for PSU bank. Now fresh banking rates, you can see here the private banks has having a higher lending rates compared to, you can see, the public sector bank. It is quite low. The reason is because whatever repo rate cut had happened, the private bank has not transferred to the end consumer, and public sector bank used to transfer it to the end consumer because it's a government organization. There's a quite a pressure from government also, but however private banks has not reduced their lending rate. That's why you can see the private banks lending rates are quite high compared to the public sector. Then see, this is what I am, transmission of repo rate cuts. So if you can see here, the transmission of repo rates, private banks, okay, it's 4.9, and for the PSU bank, public banks, it is at least below 4%. This shows that private banks are not transmitting the repo rate cut to the end consumer. Now let us see it. So the spread between the lending and the term deposit rate is 4.6 and 3.5%. So because, see, this is what profitability of normally banks is, okay. What is the profitability is that how much you are paying for the deposit and how much you are getting for the lending, okay, once you lend the money for the bank you are talking about. So suppose the suppose the bank is giving a deposit at a 5% and they are lending at a 8%. So the 3% is their profit and minus all the other expenses. So this is normally the spread. Okay. So the, you can see the spread between lending and term rate deposit at 4.6, 3.5%. So 4.6 is for private, and PSU it is 3.5%. So private bank is having larger share and larger spread because they are not transmitting the end rate, repo rate cut to the end consumer. So friends, I showed you all the what are the factors affecting the banking sector. Now we are talking about the valuation, and based on the valuation I am going to give you 5 stocks which I am bullish on. Basically we are bullish on it is that Axis Bank, DCB Bank, ICICI Bank, Karur Vysya Bank and State Bank. Now if you can see Axis Bank, okay, the upside is around 12% and the target value is around 860 rupees. Even if you see the EPS growth next this year, of course it will be high because the last year the performance was not so great. So but Dell also it was 100% and by 2024 it will be 22% growth. Okay, P is quite manageable, 18, 15 and 12. Similarly, DCB Bank, next it is expected by 70% growth, then 7%. P is also in a manageable rate. ICICI Bank is having a good EPS growth, this year 45%, next year 11%, then 2024 by 10%. P is quite high little bit, but of course it is having a premium. So P is around 21, 11 and 17. Karur Vysya Bank, a steady performer, 53%, 62, 9, and similarly P is 744. State Bank of India, one only public sector bank which you like is that you can see the EPS growth of 67, 39 and then P 12, 9 and 8. So only 8 P by 2024, it is quite undervalued. So here you can see price for book value, price divided by book value. Okay. So PB ratio is one of the most important ratio in banking sector. So for Axis Bank, it is 2.2, 2 and 1.7, which is quite good. In for DCB, it is lower than that, 1.1, 0.9 and 0.8. ICICI Bank is 3.1, 2.7, 2.4. Karur Vysya 0.6, 0.5, 0.5 and State Bank of India 1.9, 1.5, 1.3. So this shows that even from PB ratio also all these banks are quite undervalued and it's having a good future, and also the future process all these banks are quite good. So from the private sector we like Axis Bank, DCB Bank, Axis Bank and Karur Vysya, and from the public sector we like State Bank of India. Even the ROE is quite good for all these banks. You can see, and you can just pause the video and you can see all the ratios also. So friend, this is what I wanted to convey to you. Indian banking sector is going to perform well going onwards because still there is a favorable interest rate situation. Of course, real estate is coming up slowly and gradually. That impact will be shown in the Indian banking sector also. So friends, hope you like this video, and if you like this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel so you don't miss any of my future videos. Also, if you're not open a Demat account, you can click below to open a free Demat account. Me, Sietapan Doshi, signing off. Thank you very much. See you.